Childhood lupus is a condition where the body's immune system reacts for some reason against its own tissues. Up to 20% of people present in childhood, but it can affect them in many different ways. So some children will have skin or joint involvement, others it may affect a major organ so that it can have kidney disease, it can affect their neurological system so it can affect their brain or how their nerves work. Others, it can affect their heart or lungs. But the important thing is for each child to know how it's affecting them so that particular and specific treatment can be given.
I was diagnosed with arthritis when I was 8. And then at the age of 17, I was diagnosed with lupus.
Lupus, unfortunately, is potentially a fatal disease. So in young people or children who are not diagnosed, in a very aggressive form, they can actually become very unwell, and unfortunately sometimes children can die of lupus if they're not diagnosed or if they're not treated. That thankfully now is very unusual, but even so children can present to hospital very unwell, where even the doctors initially don't think about lupus. They don't think that children can get lupus sometimes, and it therefore may take a while until they diagnose it.
It was my fatigue that's been throughout my experience of lupus has been my main issue. But I did have slight lung kind of problems, a bit struggling when I was breathing deeply. I had a bit of pain, which was unusual for me. And just my mood as well, I felt low quite a lot of the time. And wasn't able to kind of pick myself back out of that easily. I think when you say to someone, yeah, I'm feeling a bit tired, everyone says, oh yeah, me too. But it's a different level. It's that your brain starts to almost kind of shut down. You're not thinking quite logically. You might even feel a bit kind of dizzy and just that you just want to be horizontal. You just want to lie down.
Prompt diagnosis and starting treatment is very important in lupus. The reason for that is that we know that if we switch the inflammation off, there's less chance of causing damage to those areas of the body affected. And therefore, in the long term, the outcome for the child or young person is better.
I think the support of family and friends is very important when you're first diagnosed, just to have someone to talk to and to keep active with, to make sure that you've got things to look forward to and that not to dwell on the bad aspects of the disease. My school was really supportive with my lupus and my arthritis. We instantly told them how I was going to cope with things and that I might need extended deadlines. The exam board was very generous. You get extra time, but you just have to tell people, you have to let them know what's going on and keep them updated, really.
There are some very important treatments in lupus. They consist of a team of people who are there to help. This is a multidisciplinary team of professionals who are very experienced in helping with all the problems that a patient with lupus might have. And then some very important medications which depend on the kind of lupus that you have. They often involve steroid medicines, at least initially, and then a range of treatments that affect the body's immune system and therefore suppress the inflammation that's causing the lupus.
At first, I did feel like, oh, my life is going to be completely different. I'm going to have to not do the things I want to do, and all my friends will be doing them, and they'll be going off and doing different things to me. And I stopped and thought, why? Why can't I go off downtown this weekend? And thought, no, I can. I just have to think it through. You have to plan a lot with lupus. You have to think, right, I've got a morning lecture, I have to get up at 9, I finish at 11, but I want to do something in the evening. I'll have a nap from after lunch from 2 till 4, get up, get ready, and then be able to have fun with my friends in the evening. It's just structuring your day and being able to think ahead.
If a child's diagnosed with lupus, obviously there's the initial phase when they're starting treatments and there can be lots to take on board. But with time and with the right treatments and particularly the right care, we'd expect them to be really managing to live as normal and as an active life as as possible, which would be going back to school, to be doing social life and games and looking towards the future.
Life is going to be more of a challenge with lupus. You do have to realise that, and you do have to manage your life more. You do have to become more organised. But I think that does, it changes you as a person. It makes you mature quicker. It makes you stronger. It makes you more understanding with other people. It is a challenge, but it's possible.